Good afternoon, sir. I am J. Ashok Kumar, working as science teacher in Atomic Energy Central School, Anupuram, Tamil Nadu. Ms. Antarlekha is my student. She has done very good, wonderful project related to an automated underground irrigation system. The same process exists in the country Israel, such a smallest country, 75 lakhs population it has. In that country, dry lands are more to avoid the evaporation of the water and to save the water. They started to make this project. But here, our students just see altered and made one innovative idea, she brought here. Now, my student Antarlekha will explain about this project.
Good afternoon, my name is Antarlekha. I am from ACS Anupuram, Tamil Nadu. So, the name of my project is an automated underground irrigation system, and my aim is to conserve water for better irrigation system. So, we all know that plants need water for their survival. They make their food by the process called photosynthesis. So, irrigation is very essential. We all know that plants absorb water from the soil. So, there are many disadvantages of having surface or irrigation. For example, if we pour water in our garden, the first reason is the water gets evaporated due to heat and also by wind. And the second reason is the water lies only a few centimeters beneath the soil. So, the plants can't absorb the water which is cannot absorb the nutrient which is present beneath the soil. So, they grow weak. So, I have introduced a system which can overcome the disadvantage of surface soil irrigation. So, in this system, there are two principles. One is electrolysis and one is electromagnetic relay. In case of electrolysis, we immerse two electrodes in soil. It contains water. So, water and soil has salt present in them like sodium chloride and magnesium chloride. So, the positive sodium ions get attracted towards the negative cathode and the negative chloride atoms get attracted towards the anode. So, current is passing through this circuit. It produces 4 volt in order to activate the electromagnet. But this current is not enough to activate the electromagnet. So, we use an amplifier in order to amplify the current into 12 volt, which is definitely used for activating this electromagnet. So, this electromagnet gets the property of magnet. So, this cantilever, which is made up of iron, gets attracted towards this electromagnet. So, now this circuit gets closed up. So, the bulb glows. It indicates that plants have enough water present in them and they can survive. So, imagine there is a plant here and it's absorbed. So, there's one stage where all the water gets dried up. So, there's no current present here and this electromagnetic loses its property. So, this cantilever gets attracted towards this place. So now this circuit gets closed up and the bulb and the buzzer glows. And with the help of the power source, this electrical water pump starts irrigating. And this water reaches the soil through this pipe and also through this perforated tube. And this cycle rotates. These are the two electrodes which help to sense how much water does the plant need. So there are many advantages of this system. The first one is, first of all, it's fully automatic. There's no person needed here. And the second one is, we can minimize the wastage of water. And the third one is, plants can absorb all the nutrients which is present beneath the soil and they grow healthy. And the fourth one is, it's very effective in our desert countries. For example, our Rajasthan, which is full of desert plants, has a Indra canal. So most of the people, they make canals and irrigate through it. So instead of making canals, we can use this system so that we can even save our precious water and have more cultivated lands. Because the population of India is increasing day by day and the production should also be increased. So I think this is a very innovative idea to have more production and even save our precious water. Thank you.